It's not the farmer that serves the most feed that gets the best result from the chickens, yeah. Hi guys, welcome back to DIY Agric, your number one animal scientist and your poultry success partner. So today I'm going to be sharing with you something that will help you to succeed exceedingly in this season. Yeah, it's season again and people are raising chickens, especially broiler chickens, for December sales, you know, and you guys want to get the best from whatever you're putting in, you know. Come to think of it, broilers eat a lot of feed and you want those feed to convert to meat, and that is exactly what I'm going to tell you, how to get the best from the feed that you are giving to your broilers. So if you are new to this channel, if you're just joining us, this is DIY Agric, that number one guy that is helping you to succeed in poultry farming. Yeah, I have over 15 years of experience, and that's not just numbers. I'm bringing all that experience here to help you succeed in the field called poultry. So today you're going to be hearing such word as FCR and also the feeding program that you are using for your birds. Yes, it's not a farmer that serves the most feed that gets the best of the results. Yes, I'll repeat that in case you missed it. It's not the farmer that serves the most feed that gets the best result from the chickens. Yeah, it just happens like that. It's not the person with the most feed that gets the best result, but who then gets the best result? Yeah, to maximize the potential of your broiler chickens, you have to do certain things that I'm going to be highlighting in this video. And if you want to get the best of it, you want to watch this video to the very end. And in case you are yet to subscribe to the channel, you want to also hit that subscribe button, because there are a lot of videos that I will be making after now and the ones I've made before now that you have access to after you hit that subscribe button. Also, if you are getting value already, click the like button to ensure that this video gets to others. Alright, so I'm talking about FCR. The FCR of your chicken is actually best when they are small. Yes, I think it applies to all farm animals. Animals generally have better FCR when they are younger. And what is FCR? It means feed conversion ratio. How much of feed you serve to produce how much of meat. Yeah, so if you serve, for example, 2 kg of feed and you are able to get 2 kg meat, which is impossible, you say they have perfect FCR. The FCR there is going to be zero, but that is not possible actually. So we are trying to maximize the FCR of our broilers, and since we know that they have better FCR from day 1 to about day 25-28, then you want to maximize that FCR. And this leads us to what we call feeding program. A lot of people believe that you don't have to feed your birds 24/7. Yeah, they may be right. And others also believe that yes, you have to feed your birds 24/7. Those ones too may be right, but there are times when you need to feed 24/7, and there are times when you need to restrict feed. And that is the logic, and that is what will help you to get the best results, you know, the best return on your investment. Okay, so once again, if you are getting value already, click the like button, hit the subscribe button if you are yet to do so. Alright, so if I'm talking about these things and I'm not referring to data, then you should believe that this thing is just crap. But I'm going to be referring to data, and that shows that you can replicate whatever is here on your own farm. You can't bank on claims that are without data, but with data you can be sure that okay, if this farmer A is able to do this on his own farm, all things being equal, if I go by what he did, I should also be able to get such result. I'll also be drawing this data from the breed performance. Yes, the performance of the breed. And the FCR for week 1 is around 0.76. I think this is for the core 500 broiler. The variation between the breeds would not be that much. So for the core 500 broiler, the FCR expectation for week 1 is about 0.76, for week 2 is about 1.03. you can see it's going up as the chicken grows. The FCR becomes poorer. So week 2 is 1.03, week 3 1.22, week 4 1.37, week 5 1.5, week 6 1.6, week 7 week 6 1.61, week 7 1.76, and continues to grow up and up like that. At week 9, you can be getting 2.04 as FCR. It's becoming poorer. So when in this broiler rearing do you need to feed ad-lib? Ad-lib means 24/7. You feed all around the clock. And when do you need to restrict feed? And when you are restricting feed, how long should you restrict the feed? Yes, I'll do justice to that. So I help you to maximize your profit this December period so that you can smile to the bank. Okay, let's continue. Very quickly, listen to my advice. From week 1, week 2, week 3, and sometimes, especially when the weather is cool, to week 4, you can actually feed ad lib. That is, you can feed the chickens all around the clock. If at all you are going to withdraw feed at all, it should be just for about 30 minutes to 1 hour during this period, and you should not even do it during week 1 and week 2. Let them have everything they need. Let them have all the light. Don't put any light out. Let them have all the light. Let them have all the food they can get, and always clean water. Always provide clean water. Most farmers don't do that, and they underestimate the power of clean water in the growth of their broilers. That is one of the reasons why I love to use automatic drinkers. If you look at my demonstration farm, you see there are automatic drinkers there. It is easier to maintain, to make the water clean in the automatic drinkers. Even if it gets dirty, once you just get into the house, all you need to do is just pour it and clean the hedges. But if you are using the manual drinkers, sometimes you just feel tired, you don't want to go and turn the water, then refill it. You know, we are humans and we get tired. All right, so week 1, 2, 3, and 4, if the weather is cool, you can give them ad lib. And at that time, because the FCR is best at that time, you are able to maximize the potential of your broilers. You don't starve them during week 1. Don't try to starve them at week 2, week 3, or 4. Don't starve them at all. So if the weather is hot, maybe during the day you get up to 32 degrees, you may want to stop feeding them ad lib at week 3. So from week 3 upwards, I mean after week 3, from week 4, you start to give them some break, especially during the hot periods of the day. So what you do then is, listen to this part now when you talk about restriction. What you do then is you fast the birds, not necessarily fast. You make sure that they go out of feed. Feed is not in their feeder during the hot periods of the day. For example, from 11 a.m. up to latest around 3-4. Yes, you tell me that there's still sun during that time. But if you are able to condition your environment, normally you shouldn't allow sun or solar radiation to enter into your pen. If you're able to condition the environment, you can just go into the chicken area. If you notice that their crop is out of feed, their feeders are out of feed, you may want to just sprinkle some feed on in the feeder so that they can get just a little feed to eat and they don't go starving. So, and you do that once the sun is out and everywhere is cool again. You check the temperature, everywhere is cool, then you can serve them the food for the evening. Let them eat that feed again throughout the night until the following morning. We are talking about maximum result here. We are talking about commercial production. We are talking about getting the best out of your broilers. I know it is possible to do it other ways. It's possible to starve your birds throughout the afternoon till late in the evening, and you then give them feed in the evening. But we are talking about a situation where you want to maximize the potential of your broilers. Yes, and mind you, there are special measures that you need to take when your chickens are sick. So from week 4, I would advise that if the weather is hot, you just give them about 4 hours break, 3 to 4 hours break in the afternoon. Don't let the break be up to 6-7 hours. If you do that, the consequence of that, it's possible you do it. People do it. I've done it before. There are extreme cases. For example, if the birds are sick, if they are CRD, and you don't want anything, eat stress at all, you may decide not to give them feed in the afternoon. Just give them water and vitamins during the afternoon so that they just cool off. But where they are healthy, you don't want to starve them for up to 6 hours. If you starve them for 6 hours, this is what happens. The chicken begins to eat itself. Is that funny? or is that strange? Is that weird? Yeah, that's what happens. The chickens begin to eat themselves. What does that mean? It means that they begin to reduce in weight. Their weight begins to reduce because all the fatty tissues laid down, the body begins to convert it into energy for the broiler. So that's why you don't want to fast them for up to 6-7 hours, 3 to 4 hours maximum. And if you notice that the weather is still hot, you can just give them just tiny bits of feed just to have something in their crop. It may not be enough for them, but at least it will help hold the weight so that the weight doesn't start going down. And let me slot this in. Ensure to provide your broilers with cool water, cool and fresh water throughout the day, especially during the hot afternoon. Make sure that you give them cool water. If you are able to put ice block in their water tank so that the water becomes cool, you may be able to cool the body temperature of your birds, and in that case you won't be having heat flashes and you won't be having sudden deaths among your broiler flock. Now, a lot of people reach out to me and they say, you know, you get 2 point something kg in 5 weeks. How do you do that? These are some of the things that I do, and it's possible. It's something you can replicate. This is fact from Cop 500 breed, those who manufacture the breed. So if they said it and have tried it, it worked for me not once, not twice, times without number, then I believe that the things I'm telling you, you can also do it on your farm, and it's gonna work for you, you know? So all of us deserve bounty harvest this December. Feed prices are high, even the chicks are as high as $1 per chick, you know? So you really need to up your game to get the best results, and I wish you a bounty harvest this season. Thank you once again for watching DIY Agric, your number one animal scientist and your poultry success partner. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. See you in the next one. Bye.